Welcome to the Growing Food and Feeding People podcast. Whether you're a backyard gardener, a market gardener, or a small-scale farmer, just starting out, or a seasoned grower, this show is for you. Join us as we share tips and tricks, tactics and hacks, growing food for yourself, your family, and your community, as well as sharing stories here from the field and other growers and farmers making a difference in their local food webs. My name is Cody, and I will be your host, so let's get growing. All right, episode one, season one of the Growing Food and Feeding People podcast is finally here. The show is brought to you by Simply and Easy Media, and this episode is sponsored by Simplistic Farms, bringing fresh local produce to West Michigan, one family at a time. I want to thank you guys for joining me. This has been a long time coming. And when I say long time, I distinctly remember as a child, my father coming up to me and saying, "Son, you've got a face made for radio." So I believe this will be a great fit. But all joking aside, guys, timing is everything. This podcast has been in the works, kind of on the back burner for about a year now. And I cannot be happier to finally bring it to fruition. Yeah, timing is everything. We'll get into that a little bit later. But in this episode, we are going to talk about kind of what to expect from the podcast moving forward. We're going to discuss maybe why we would even want to start a podcast, how we're going to go about it, and we'll talk a little bit about the direction we're taking with the farm. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. So what exactly can you expect from the podcast? Well, the first thing you can expect is a new episode every single week. We are committed to producing and releasing an episode every week, Tuesday morning at 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. So you can expect that, and we will be covering all things growing food and feeding people. We aren't going to focus just on market gardening. We will talk a lot about that, but we are also going to be highlighting and having some guests on from your backyard gardeners to market gardeners, small-scale farmers, and maybe even some local chefs that promote farm-to-table as well. So this is going to be a place for a conversation, and yeah, we'll be covering all aspects of it. From, you know, starting a farm to starting a garden, individual crops, best practices for those, different techniques of trellising. We will cover marketing for the farm and garden, crop planning, all aspects of it. So we're not going to limit ourselves to one small area. We're going to have a lot of discussions. So that is kind of what you can expect. Now, you might be asking, why even start a podcast? And there's a few reasons for it, really. It is definitely an extension of our YouTube channel. Our YouTube channel is Simple and Easy, Simplistic Farms. And we love producing content for that. But most of our content that we create for YouTube is going to be between 5 and 15 minutes. That seems to be about the right duration to hold people's attention and to get some value across. So starting a podcast will allow me to extend that audience, really to be able to dive a little bit deeper into the subjects maybe that we cover on there. It'll also allow us to reach a little bit broader audience. You know, we are fully aware that not everybody watches YouTube, and not everybody watches farm and garden channels on YouTube when they do go on there. So this is another way to reach and bring value to the world. So we kind of felt it was the next logical step. But all honesty, the biggest reason is probably because I've become very passionate about growing food and feeding people and encouraging and helping others do the same. I'm always trying to figure out how we can better serve our communities and how we can reach more of them. So we will be focusing a lot on that because that's really the driving force behind most of what I do these days. I myself really enjoy podcasts during the day when I'm out in the field working. I almost always have one on, whether it be because I want to learn something or I just want to be entertained. I usually have one playing. So it definitely allows us to dive deeper and have more meaningful conversations, bring new voices into the conversation, because I believe that different perspectives are definitely of value, yet easily overlooked these days, it seems. And the other reason is really I've grown to appreciate and understand the power of community and the amazing things that can be accomplished when people of like minds come together online. It can really be quite incredible. So those would be the reasons why we're starting this podcast. And I believe we've got something to add to the community that it might be missing. As more and more people are understanding the benefits of growing their own food, I think we also need to focus on growing food for those around us as well that may not be able to, whether it be because of resources, time, or physical abilities. I think sometimes it's real easy to get caught up in the growing of the food and the marketing and selling of the food and the economics of the farm, that it's really easy to forget about those that are less fortunate and who might be most in need of the food that we're growing. So I do want to focus on that for sure, and that is kind of the direction we're going to go with the farm a little bit next year. So like I said, we'll get into that more probably in another episode, but I'm really liking the idea, just as a little teaser here, of an online farm feeding an offline community. So chew on that a little bit, and we'll definitely have some deep discussions about it. Our mission here at the farm via our YouTube channel and the podcast has become to help feed 10,000 families across the country through the implementation of online farm businesses. And we are going to be launching Project Feed Your Neighbor and starting a Feed Your Neighbor Challenge next spring. So you guys can look out for those as well. So we are going to basically be using our farm as a proof of concept farm, which it's been since its conception. I think this is a concept that could make a big difference. So what are we doing on the farm right now? This week, we are back to harvesting lettuce. We're going to be making our salad mix this week. It got pretty hot in August here in Michigan. So we pretty much stopped the production of our salad mix. But it's time to harvest some more of that. So we've got some pretty happy customers. We are still producing a ton of tomatoes. We've got a lot of carrots that are ready to be harvested. We've got some cool weather broccoli coming on now and some cabbage heads forming. We pretty well winded down our cucumbers, but we do have the green beans are still cranking, and we've got a new bed of those that will probably be harvesting beans off in another 2 weeks. So that's kind of what we're doing here on the farm. We are still flipping beds to produce hopefully into November, maybe December. Some of the beds are winded down, so like I say, we've taken down and cleaned up our cucumber beds, and some of our summer crops are starting to wind down. Our melon tunnel has been a huge hit and has produced unbelievably, so we will be harvesting the rest of the melons off of that here in the next week, maybe 2 weeks, and looking forward to our winter squash and pumpkins that are coming on as well. So that's kind of what we're doing here on the farm, looking towards fall. Looking to get out and do a little hunting, fill in the freezer that way as well. And just enjoying Mother Nature as we try to do every single day. So that's kind of what's going on here on the farm. All right, that goat is telling us it is time for the Farm and Garden Word of the Week. And this week's word is occultation. So this is going to be a fun little game we play each week. And it is going to be multiple choice. Is occultation in the garden A, secret society of farmers hell-bent on world domination, B, a dance party for microbes, C, a process using tarps and thyme to kill weeds prior to planting out your beds, or D, all of the above? I'll give you a second to think about that one. All right, guys, that is C. Occultation is a process using tarps and thyme as a method to kill off your weeds at the beginning of the season prior to planting out your beds. That's a process in which I use on the beds that I have time to use it for, and it works great. So hopefully you either got a laugh out of that or you learned something. And either way, hopefully we're bringing value. So guys, this has been a great time. I cannot thank you enough for joining me. We are going to have some ways that you can get involved in what we're doing a little bit further down the road, and we'll get into that probably in the next episode or so. But again, I cannot thank you enough for joining me. I am very excited to be bringing this podcast to fruition. And if you'd like to continue the conversation, you can find us over on Facebook at Simplistic Farms LLC, and we would definitely love to chat over there. And you can check us out on YouTube at Simple Ain't Easy, Simplistic Farms. Until next week, you guys have a good one. We'll talk to you then.